Sushant Arunachalam, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Now you can share your screen.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah. Screen is visible.
Okay, sir. Sagashri?
Yeah.
Am I audible?
Slightly
yes.
Increase your voice. Increase your voice.
Sir, now is it okay, sir?
Yeah, now it's audible.
Okay, sir. A warm welcome to all. Hope everybody is safe. Myself, Sagashri. And my teammate Sushant Karunachalam, pursuing our final year at Rajalakshmi Institute of Technology, along with our mentor, Dr. R. Lalita, who is an alumni of IRTT College. And we have come up with a project that is an automated approach to inspect social distancing through drone using deep learning technique. Okay. COVID-19 is a very dreadful disease that all of us are facing. It's completely a very new experience for all of us. Like, it's brought so many changes. We are instructed to wear masks and maintain social distancing. It's almost going to be a year since this COVID started, and yet we haven't returned back to our usual life. It's really a tough time for all police department to maintain and monitor people if they are maintaining social distancing and if they're wearing masks. So in this case, it is impossible for one person to monitor a huge crowd of people. So we have come up with an idea of replacing a drone with a police person who is in charge of monitoring people. To make this software part a bit simple, we have chosen the IBM platform. Here, the drone has a camera and that monitors people. And we have used the IBM visual recognition to train and detect people without mask and social distancing. So the IBM Tello drone flow and the visual recognition are deployed to the cloud. If it predicts people without mask or social distancing, then it raises a warning voice note. So this is a mural hypothesis. Hypothesis is nothing but a pictorial, it's pictorially giving a clarity about the project. So here it covers these topics like the problems, users, beneficial end users, features of the project and the assumptions that we have taken. So the problem is that to monitor people, if they maintain social distancing or not, that's the problem. And the users will be police, government, licensed drone operator, and public people. And the benefits is for the public and social distancing, so that it detects people without social distancing and mask. It helps the government. So this is all about the mural hypothesis. These are the features that this particular project covers.
So this is the pictorial view of our user interface, drone user interface, which we have designed using IBM Tello drone servers. So next is the drone interface, user interface, where we will give a command to the Tello drone to take picture, and the preview of the image will be displayed here, and the results will be based on the visual recognition object detection model which we have built using IBM services. So here the model has predicted no social distance of 0.44% and the mask of 0.36%. So let me show you the demo video of the prediction results of our IBM visual recognition object detection model. So this is the visual recognition service. So here I'm going to test the model by providing some test images. So I am selecting some random images of social distance, no social distance. Now the model has predicted social distance of 0.38% for each image based on the model trained. So this is the demo video of our visual recognition model. So now we have built a visual recognition service for detecting a social distance or no social distance, mask or non-mask. So in order to schedule this process as a flow, we have built an application using Pega platform. So the main reason for this, the reason is behind that, the beneficial users are the government and the public people and police people. So it requires hierarchical implementation of this particular inspection process has to be carried out hierarchically and legally by approvals. So this application consists of three stages. So let me show you the application which I have built using Pega platform. So this is a case life cycle of our application. So first, there are three stages involved in this application. So first, the scheduler, there are three persons involved in this project. One is the scheduler, he will schedule the inspection process. And the second person is the higher authority who will be approving or rejecting this schedule process. And after the approval by higher authority, the case proceeds to the inspection process where the drone will be subjected to perform inspection in the public places. So here the three persons are involved, and this is the case life cycle of our application. So so this is the stages which we have built using Pega platform. So let me execute this flow. So already the three people's email ID have been created in Pega platform. So first, I'm going to begin this case life cycle by logging in as scheduler scheduling inspection. So scheduler at inspection.com, and this is a portal which I have designed for this application. So this scheduler at inspection.com will be directed to scheduler portal. So this scheduler portal will have a case where he can schedule the inspection process. It's loading. So the respective scheduler can schedule the inspection by clicking this image. A case will be created for scheduling this inspection process. So here the scheduler will enter the scheduled time, scheduled date, and the drone which they are going to use for the inspection process. So he's selecting the Tello drone. And the schedule time will be around 2 p.m. And the schedule date will be tomorrow, 26th. And I'm selecting the country and the state as Tamil Nadu and city as Annanagar. Now I'm giving the address details here. I'm entering the address details. So the scheduler details I'm entering, the person who is scheduling, his details will be collected. Mobile number will be entered. His email ID will be entered. So these details will be, when he submits the form, he can review the details, such as what he has entered, he can review, and these details will be stored in the database. So let me parallelly show you that also. So now after submitting this form, the case will be routed to the approval stage, where the required higher authority will be approving this scheduling process. So let me show you the next portal. Before that, I wanted to show the data which is stored. So here the schedule details are stored here, and now I'm logging out and logging in as the higher authority portal. So manager@inspection.com. So the higher authority will be redirected to manager portal, and this is a case, latest case. So now the manager can approve or reject the schedule inspection. So he can view the schedule date, choose the drone chosen and the time chosen, and the scheduler details will be displayed here for his reference. So now the higher authority will be approving this request. Now the case will be routed to the inspector who is going to perform the inspection process. So let me log into the inspector portal. Now the inspector will be redirected to inspector portal, and he can perform the inspection process by clicking this. So now I'll be here. Since the drone is not available, we are simulating the drone interface. So let me show you the drone, Telodrone UI interface by clicking this link here. So this is a IBM Telodrone service UI user interface, which you could. So here the controls are there for controlling the Telodrone from the laptop or the application. So here they can take off, land, they can move the drone up or down. So this is the control dashboard. And this is the telemetry data, where the statistic level of the drone will be displayed here, such as battery level, acceleration level, and speed levels are displayed here. And they can control, the controls for controlling the drone are available here. And let me switch to the Telo camera dashboard. So here the drone will be taking a picture, and the preview of the image will be displayed here, and the results will be displayed based on the visual recognition which I have built, which I showed you in the demo video. So this is a user interface used for that. And the Telo camera dashboard. So here we can start a visual recognition service and end the visual recognition service, and the results will be displayed accordingly. And this is the mass detection portal. Since the service is not available, so this is the user interface which we have designed. So now let's assume that the inspection process is over. So now the inspector has finished the inspection process, and he is noting down the observations here. So the duration of flight of the drone was 20 minutes, and number of masks given to the person will be around 8, and how many times the drone went towards the people, 7. Based on the inspector's feedback, less inspection is required, or medium inspection is required, anything you can give. So these details will be reviewed again by the inspector for his reference, and these details will be routed to the manager for a notification. So here the email has been sent. So the manager, the respective higher authority will be notified that this many masks have been given, and the inspection flight has been here. And the real time, we have implemented real time mail also. So yeah, the user will be notified. The manager will be notified with the Gmail account. So he can see here, he can review this. And we have designed reports also. So let me show you the reports in the manager portal. I'm logging into the manager portal. So he can click, the manager can click the reports button, and he can see the list of reports. So here we have designed three reports. So this is a scheduled report based on the inspection details which we have entered, that is such as the masks given. So this is the reports based on the scheduled date. The reports will be recorded here so the manager can view for his reference. So this is one of the report, and scheduled report is the pictorial representation of how many masks have been given to the people based on the date. In this particular date, this many masks have been given to the people. So that data will be displayed in this report. And the third report is the schedule details. So based on the schedule date, how many schedules have been scheduled? That details will be displayed in this report. And the particular data, inspection data, will be stored in this database. So I've entered the scheduler details have been saved here, and the inspection details have been saved here. So this is the working of our application. So Sabashri, you can continue.
Okay, now let's get into the advantages of this particular project. So it can be used by police, government in order to monitor people in public place. It can also be used during night time. So this we wanted to make it to be used even during night. So this is an advantage with the replacement of the camera. And the next is by fixing a box to the drone, by changing the payload of the particular drone, a small weightless minimum weight paper box or something could be placed with a few masks in it and can be stored, and it also can be picked by people if they do not have one. So it could be used even in
Kaliram sir
drone period.
Kaliram sir,
so the future enhancement, the existing model, like the model that we have now, it only predicts people if they do not wear mask or if they do not maintain social distancing, and it raises a warning voice note saying that they are not maintaining things, they are not wearing a mask, and it just warns them. So that warning voice note will be played. So this is a exact existing model. So as a future enhancement,
Kaliram,
I will show
Kaliram
the
sir
voice note output also.
Kaliram sir, Kaliram sir,
sorry for interrupting, forgot to show that. So we have designed an automated speech flow using IBM text to speech service, which will be invoked when it predicts no social distance or people if they don't wear mask. This flow will be invoked automatically. So I'm injecting here. So the text-to-speech service will be invoked, and the audio will be played. So this voice note will be played when it detects no social distance is maintained or no masks are maintained. So this is the output of the voice note.
So as a future enhancement, the model will be made to chase people further if they do not follow the rules. That would be a future enhancement. So we are working on it. Next is the query session. Usually when we presented this project, we collected few questions that were frequently asked by people to us. So we wanted to give answers right here. So these are few questions that we have put up here. What is the drone specification and camera resolution? This is the first question that everybody raises. So we prefer using a 4K camera with around 8 million pixels resolution with a battery capacity of 45 minutes. Like we are making a prototype. So for now, we are planning to make with a 45 minutes battery capacity. The next is which algorithm is used? This is completely based on deep learning algorithms. And the next is, how do you predict distance? So we use Euclidean distance formula. We consider two people, like the distance between two people is calculated. How it is calculated is, it considers people as frames. It considers two people inside a frame, and the distance and the height and width of the frame is calculated. With that, the distance between two people is predicted. When this question is raised, the next question is, at the side angles, how does it detect the distance between two people? So they will be diagonal, they will look like as though they are together. Maybe from some of the view, they will look like they are apart. So how we detect that is, basically drone is not a stable thing. It keeps moving. So it is not a CCTV camera. We don't fix it somewhere and then we detect something. So it keeps predicting in all possible directions. So we need not worry about this. Because obviously when the drone moves to all the sides, when it covers few sides, it will predict, if not in one direction, in another direction, it will automatically predict. From side view, it will be very obvious. It's not going to be stable thing. So this side angle, that is an answer for that. So it is based on COVID-19. So what is the scope of this project after returning to normal life?
Kaliram sir.
This particular project can be implemented in any
Kaliram, sir.
Process, in any place, changing the data set. It simply works with the data, how we train them and things like that. So when we change it, we can implement it in some other place. And the last is, what is the accuracy? When it comes to accuracy, it's based on data sets. And so we have given so many data sets, and based on the confidence score that we have got, with the average of the confidence score, we have come up with an accuracy of 85%. This accuracy is not like we are putting it up. These are derived from the data sets that we have given, trained the data sets. That is, we have trained the model with. So with that only, we have come with a conclusion of 85% accuracy. And the last question is, the main reason is to help the police department and safeguard lives of people who do not, you know, stick on to the rules. So this is all about the project, and thanks one and all for giving us this opportunity. Thank you.
Okay, Sushan, just scroll down your PPT. Just I want to clarify some doubts, that's all. No more doubts, no more questions, but just I want to clarify some doubts. Scroll down your PPT starting from first page. Go to first page, go to title, to inspect the social distance through drone using deep learning technique. Okay, then second page. Then third page. Fourth page. Fifth page. Sixth, next. Okay, pictorial view of drone UI, back to previous page. Pictorial view of drone UI, whether you are, you have to download separately in your laptop or what, if you just interface your drone, you will get this like, this front end like this.
No, sir. Actually, this is a IBM Tello drone service.
Okay.
So this is the UI we have.
So, do you have that software in your department?
No, sir. Actually, it's not at to download. You can create a service in the IBM platform, sir. We can create a service and.
Okay. So it's a free, or you have to pay some money for that, or
it
some you
free,
have to
sir,
give some
actually.
Letter from your college.
Sir.
Whether it is free or whether it is payable or whether you get certificate from your institution and just upload
no,
in
no,
your
sir. I'll just show you right now.
They are giving trial experience for us. It is free, and beyond that experience they will ask us to pay. And we had actually participated in IBM Hack Challenge last year, and we were the winners.
Yeah, just
so
just like IoT platform.
No,
yes,
sir.
Yeah, you just like IoT platform cloud. Okay.
Yeah, it's a cloud platform.
Mm.
The services which you can use, you can download, you can just create the services here.
Sir, it's not like if we create, we get only the skeleton of it. We need to install node. We need to
Okay,
create nodes to run that in those projects.
you are create you are creating all those work in your IBM platform cloud. Okay, the person wearing mask or not, something like that, to whom you are going to inform?
Sir, it is for that only we have created the application, so it is hierarchically. Like if the police are in charge for inspection process, then the next higher authority will be the person who will be
No,
instructing the inspection.
okay. You are going to alert whom? Whether public or
Not the public, sir.
what?
Definitely not the public, sir. It is for the purpose of the government.
Government, okay. Government is going to alert what? Public or.
That's why, sir, for the higher authority, we are sending the email, the duration
Okay.
of
They are
the
going
number
to.
given on the police warrant. Basically, the higher authority.
Isolate that particular person. What?
Sir, he will be a licensed drone user, sir. He'll be
No,
procured.
whether they are going to isolate the person who is not wearing the mask.
Sir, I
No,
used to know that.
you are going to identify the person not wearing the mask. Like, okay.
Okay, sir. Yes.
Okay, right. Okay. Then what you are doing in your project?
Sir, it is actually a survey. Like, we are implementing an inspection process here, and it is taking, we are implementing it in a hierarchical way, and we are checking if it is useful. Like, if the area is under control or not, if people are following it or not. If people are following it and it has come to control, then there is there th this it cannot be implemented further. Then we move on to the next area. So until people start following the rules, it will be implemented, sir. So like that, we are like surveying people if people follow or
Okay,
not.
which deep learning technique you are using in your project? Which deep learning technique?
First, we used a YOLO algorithm, sir. We published a paper also, journal paper also based on that. And based on this, after we participated in IBM challenge, we switched to IBM platform.
Okay.
So these are the results obtained by the YOLO algorithm. So you can see here the same prediction results is also obtained in IBM platform also. So let
Okay.
me show you the image.
Okay.
It's loading.
So you are using YOLO. Okay, YOLO algorithm. Some other else in your deep learning technique?
No, sir, only YOLO algorithm.
YOLO algorithm only. Okay. Okay. Right. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Sushant. Okay. Right.
Thank you so much, sir,
Thank
for
you.
giving us this wonderful
Thank
opportunity.
you, participants. We have confirmed honorable mention to the two honorable mention goes to two honorable mention go to what IRTT students, and the prizes 1, 2, 3 we have marks allotted, but those marks are for 2 or 3 projects we are getting same marks. All are very good projects. So 2 or 3 projects are getting same marks for first, second, three. So we have to conclude within today evening. We will inform it in our WhatsApp group within today night. Okay, whether the prize will be shareable or what, that will be discussed with our another coordinator and head of the department. We will inform within today night.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any other questions? Any other doubts? Participants, any other doubts?
No, sir.
Sushant, any other doubt? Pranav
No, sir.
Kumar,
No doubt.
Pranav, your voice is not audible. Pranav, your voice is not audible.
Sir, one second, sir.
Hello? Your voice is not that that much audible, Pranav. You maybe some outside, something like that.
Sir, is it audible now, sir?
No, I'm not able to hear your voice.
So one second, sir, I adjust the sound.
Okay.
Sir, now is it now audible, sir?
Now audible. Okay.
Sir, actually in the last project, sir, the sister explained.
Okay, you better post it in the chat box. Chat box, you post your queries in the chat box or in our WhatsApp group. And Pranav, I want to inform one more thing. Two honorable mention prizes goes to V. Harish, IRTT ECE department, second year, and Amrish Chandrasekharan, third year ECE IRTT. And the prizes first, second, third will be shared two or three participant batches may be shared for prize one, for first prize, second prize, third prize, two or three participant teammates have a same score. So we have to discuss and we have to finalize within today night. We will inform it to you. Okay, right? Okay. And then best audience, we are going to give one more additional award. Best audience, that is going to Pranav Kumar from Mahalingam College of Engineering and Technology.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, only one best audience, that is going to Mr. Pranav Kumar from Mahalingam College of Engineering and Technology.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, anything do you want to say or you want to share? Come to our WhatsApp group, we will discuss.
Sir, sure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Shall we wind up? Sushant.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.